We've been traveling together for some time now, haven't we? As a result, we move as one. Gigantus, friend or foe? Indeed. And where is it bound, I wonder?
I cannot but fear it will bring ruin wherever it treads.
Not retreat soon. I fear we are all lost. We ought press on, my lord.
Mind not the stone puppet, then. We move.
It arose from the sea. What could have summoned it?
Appears to be pursuing Lord Phasis.
At last!
It all becomes clear. you in but a moment. A fine place to harvest some ingredients.
I know precisely when a curative is needed, Master. You'll never fall in battle so long as I'm around. I hope I can count on you in a scrape. It appears we've found a ballista.
It is not how we use this, but when that counts. I imagine it would be most beneficial in combat.
Are unparalleled in their majesty, yet somehow I feel ill at ease.
It is a lonely place, to be sure.
We've heard a lot about this Lord.
Greetings, Sir Arisen. Have you come to enjoy the waters of the curative spring yourself? The injury I sustained in Her Majesty's defense is healing steadily, yet 'twill be some time before I am ready to leave. Though I am grateful for this opportunity to convalesce, I grow restless, as there is a matter I wish to investigate post-haste. Perhaps you would look into it on my behalf? I wish to know the identity of the villain who orchestrated the attempt on the Empress's life. The rogue you captured has been questioned at length, but last I heard has yet to reveal this information. Methinks you might fare better at breaking his silence. So, the brigand claims to have been employed by the Coral Snakes. Interesting. Whoever is truly behind this has covered their tracks well. But if Her Majesty is to be protected, we must flush the betrayer out at all costs. Might I beg a moment of your time, sirs? What I'm about to reveal is known only to a select few in all Batal. I trust you will be prudent. During his interrogation, the brigand let slip that another assassin would be sent to kill the Empress. In the name of caution, Her Majesty has taken up residence in a location known only to me. There she will remain till the danger has passed. With Her Majesty safe, and the knowledge of the Coral Snake's involvement under our belt, 'tis time for us to make our move. Yes, Sir Arisen. I mean to draw the villain who set the scheme in motion out of the shadows in which they lurk. My plan is thus. You will inform the Coral Snakes of the Empress's location. A false one, of course. Tell them that you have her in your custody. And that if they wish to confirm her identity, they must come to the empty abode south along Flamebearer Palace Road. 'Tis my hope that this will lure the mastermind to the fall. For you.
I say we speak with anyone and everyone who springs to mind. You never know what sort of useful tidbits we might turn up. To share information with the Coral Snakes to lure out our foe. Mayhap the jail is our best avenue for this.
That's like to make me sick, it is. Still, there's not a swig of newt liquor can't fix, I always say. Bollocks, I'm all out. Boy there, come at a fine time, you have. Care for a rotten egg? 'Twas soft boiled right here in the hot spring. 'Tis mostly sand. Won't kill you, nor. You a bold one. Here you are.
These writings could be of import.
Shall we take a closer look?
Puh! That's like to make me sick, it is. Still, there's not a swig of Nootlick I can't fix, I always say. Bollocks, I'm all out. Boy there, come at a fine time, you have. Care for a rotten egg? To a soft boil right here in the hot spring. Tis mostly sand, won't kill you, no. Bought me some newt liquor, have ye? Many thanks, Coz. Don't mind if I do. Aye, that's the stuff. There's naught finer than a gulp of newt liquor. After a hot bath, tis bliss, pure and simple. But I'll need me a nibble to go with my glug. Down the hatch. Aye. This is a dream come true, tis. Suppose you deserve aught for your trouble. Here you are, cuz. A soft-boiled egg, specially prepared right here in the hot spring.
I expect Sir Lamond will further loosen his lips if we continue to gift him newt liquor.
Are you quite...
Well now, if it ain't the current arisen. Have you come for a dip in the hot spring? Or mayhap to speak with me. Aye. That's the stuff. Thanks for this, cuz. Yeah, too kind. Ah, warms you right up, it does. You're welcome to bring me more of this whenever you like. Suppose you deserve aught for your trouble. Here you are, cuz. A soft-boiled egg, specially prepared right here in the hot spring. Well now, if it ain't the current arisen. Fair. Have you come for a dip in the hot spring? Or mayhap to speak with me? Ha ha! Brilliant! That's kind of ye. I was just craving some more of this. But what are you hoping for, cuz? Some sort of boon? Suppose I could oblige a fellow arisen. What? Hadn't you noticed? That's a bit embarrassing, eh? I'm a former arisen. Mine, one who couldn't fell his dragon. And if there's aught more shameful than that, I've yet to hear of it. In my case, it all came down to a lack of skill. Mayhap I could fell such a beast now, but my dragon's long gone. Brings a tear to your eye, don't it? But don't cry for me, cuz. Just know that you've got my full support. I'd be glad to see ye succeed where I once failed. Only, don't do it for me. Do it for yourself. Bring your dragon low, and taste glory eternal. Just remembered, I've got something for ye, cuz. Here ye are. Reckon ye'll make good use of it.
Fancy a look at my wares? Greetings. I expect you must be weary from your travels, but you...
Its healing waters draw upon the volcano's natural heat. Take a dip, and your fatigue shall melt away in moments.
Always a pleasure. wares.
I feel as good as new. Let the adventure continue. I'll be ready to tackle whatever comes.
Understood.
Now, the arse on the throne changes every few decades or so, but the sun up in the sky is the same one that always was.
Took nary a moment. Now that we're here, what did you have in mind, Arisen?
No one's coming to my rescue. As I well know. Is there any
thrilling life? I might stay.
Well met.
I'm going to explore it.
Materials, eh? I shan't deny, they have their uses.
We scholars must gird ourselves with
the last. The puzzle begins to take shape.
Right. We shall wait here till your business is done.
What do you want? You've got the Empress. This some kind of jape? Suppose the fact you're telling this to me means you're in the know. You one of us? Right then, I'll pass these tidings along to our interested party. Where should I tell them to find you? The empty house south of the Pilgrim's Path, is it? Fair enough. Fear not. I'll arrange for the interested party to meet you in the empty house, south of the Pilgrim's Path.
I have been waiting for you, Arisen.
Ah, that's right. I must fetch those papers.
Sir Arisen, I take it you have given the Coral Snakes the information we discussed. Then the villain behind Her Majesty's assassination will doubtless be compelled to act with all due haste. And so must we. Let us begin our preparations presently.
Thank you.
If I might be so bold as to speak my mind, the private quarters of one Arisen I served had many a visitor, and rarely the same one.
Fascinating.
Might I implore you to play the part of a bandit, Sir Arisen? As one of Her Majesty's champions, my face is like as not to be known to our villain. I have also employed the aid of a woman resembling Her Majesty in stature and build. She will fulfill the role of Empress during the exchange.
No, Manella. We must go ourselves.
Your Majesty, I don't think...
Should the ruse be discovered too soon, the renegade may flee and escape justice. We must confront them, so that our land and its people may ne'er endure such uncertainty again.
Understood. Then I shall guard your Majesty with my life. We must needs be ready for whate'er comes, Sir Arisen. Pray, tell me when you are prepared.
Seems you are called upon to act alone, so we pawns shall join your audience. I do hope you play your part well.
Right you are.
I suspect the villain will approach under cover of night. Are your preparations concluded? I am glad to hear it, and not a moment too soon. We have received word that someone approaches our location. Find a way to loosen the villain's tongue. I shall remain hidden till the opportune moment presents itself. May all go as planned.
I am come. Would you kindly open the door? Let us not waste time. I am here to confirm the identity of your captive and naught else. Where might she be? Indeed. 'Tis the Empress and none other, fortunately for you. Had it been anyone else, your head would now be free of its shoulders. 'Tis by the Coral Snakes' failure that she yet lives. I trust you are prepared to rectify this mistake. Go on, kill her. That is far enough. You must forgive me. I suspected foul dealings from the moment I heard the Empress was being held here. However, with this display, you have earned my trust. In truth, she cannot die here. We must have her meet her, and in a place more fitting. Tell me, do you know what it takes to inspire action in this world? Tragedy. Yes, tragedy. The emotion that floods forth in the wake of such events can change the world entire. Consider what a tragedy of singular measure, such as that of a great leader martyred for her ideals, could achieve. Why, the flames of revolution would burn eternal. A worthy funeral pyre for an empress, wouldn't you agree? And so Her Majesty's tragedy must be made a spectacle of, that all Batal might bear witness and shed tears of blood.
So this was your aim. It all becomes clear.
On your knees, we have you surrounded. Sir Armhild! So it was you!
Manella, this little ruse was your doing, I suppose. And as for your Majesty, I must say I am disappointed. You would go so far to save your own neck, rather than do what is best for the future of this country.
We understand what you desired to achieve, yet we also believe that no ideal can truly be born from bloodshed. Perhaps you will ponder this in your solitude. By our authority as Empress, we hereby place you under arrest.
Ermhild's was a vile plot. I only hope she is the last villain seeking to advance her aims through murder.
This quest took many turns, but at last it has reached its conclusion.
We pity Irmhild, but her ideals are not our own. We do not believe that Batal would be best served by a martyred empress.
I shall escort Sir Irmhild to her cell. I cannot thank you enough for your aid in this matter, Sir Arisen.
That fool understands naught. Does she think she can exact change in this world through goodwill alone?
We've no cause to visit a campsite as yet, methinks. It is enough to make camp only when the need arises.
What do you want? I'm in no mood to have my ear talked off, thank you. My back's afire. I can scarce talk for the pain. Leave an old man be. Mind, I wouldn't say no to some wildflowers, if you happen to have any with you. A handful of those, and I could prepare a poultice that'd help me make it home.
It's about time we pressed on, wouldn't you say, Master?
What is it now? Unless you've brought me some wildflowers, I'd prefer to be left alone. Well, that was most kind of you. My thanks for the trouble. Right, here goes naught. A relief at last. I was beginning to fear that I'd be stuck here for the rest of my days. I've a mind to thank you, sir. Would you look in on me at my home? I live nearby. There aren't too many houses out here, so you'll find it soon enough, I expect. I'd fain reward you. Tisn't far.
Can't wait to find out what's inside.
My thanks.
I'll harvest what I can, should it please you.
I? Beg pardon, sir, but...
Forgive me, dear. I forgot to tell you. I asked this good sir to look in on me.
Oh, not this again. How many times have I begged you not to bring strangers into our home?
I know, dear, but this one's a kindly sort. Brought me the wildflowers I needed to make it home when I threw out my back.
'Tis always one reason or another, isn't it? And has it e'er ended well for us? Not once. Mark my words, no one wanders this far out unless they are running from something.
This one's different, I promise you. You've heard tell of the Arisen, have you not? The hero who travels far and wide to track and fell the dragon.
Oh? So this stranger claims to be the Arisen? Believe what you will, but expect no hospitality from me. You may tend to our guest yourself.
You will have to forgive my wife. She has her reasons for being mistrusting, but you deserved a warmer welcome than that. Now let me fetch your reward. Wait here a moment.
You would gather material. Here you are, Master. I hope you like it. I found it myself.
With the port crystal placed, we'll be able to use a fairy stone to return here in an instant.
Oh! Fie! My back! I've done it in again!
Gout Stuffer, when will you learn to be more gentle with yourself?
Oh, hold your tongue! All the gentleness in the world won't stop the hurt from coming on when twill. It's only gotten worse of late. There's naught for it but to make for the curative spring.
In your state, you'll ne'er reach it. And that's to say nothing of the monsters that haunt the roads out there. They'll be on you in a moment if they see you limping along on your own. Oh, would that I could take you to the spring myself, but alas, I...
Don't even think on it, my dear. I'd not ask that of you, knowing how crowded places of that ilk make you feel.
But what are we to do? I fear for you, my love.
Wait, those shards are worth their weight in gold, when one has enough of them to combine.
We ought to keep it with care, lest we lose it.
Fear not. You'll have your reward. I just need to sit still a moment. You'd be willing to accompany me all that way? You see, my dear, what did I tell you? The Arisen's a goodly sort. I have an eye for people.
Don't be a fool, Gaustuffer. You have barely spoken to this person. What if you were being deceived? Did you think of that?
Come. Surely there are far more clever lies to tell if one's intent is to swindle. I'm not sure I can afford to refuse aid so freely given, my dear.
So be it, then. 'Tis plain your mind's made up.
We'd best be along. My back isn't like to fix itself.
Pray see my husband safely to the encampment. I shall await your return. Pray see my husband safely to the encampment. I shall await your return.
Wish me to return at once, Master.
Understood.
moment I've been waiting for. Allow me to gather these up.
Dare I say it? We trounced our foe, well and true.
We mustn't allow ourselves to become complacent. Take each trial as it comes.
Thank you.
searing heat or freezing cold. Which is the greater hardship, I wonder?
Remain focused. A clouded mind shall serve you poorly in an ambush. Materials, eh? I shan't deny, they have their uses.
You'd think they'd have learned from that last lot that we're not to be trifled with.
If battle cannot be avoided, 'tis fight or die. Of course. We are to retreat, then? Let us defer to the Arisen's judgment. Right you are.
Could I trouble you to walk a wee bit slower? My back is like to...
I'll harvest what I can, should it please you.
This ladder looks sturdy enough to climb. Ah, excellent find.
Chest? What harm could there be in having a peek?
Must you run so fast? I can hardly keep you in my sights, Arisen!
Let us endeavor to keep up, though we are less fleet of foot. I've just had a thought.
Fancy a look at my wares?
At last, I've ne'er seen a more welcome sight. The spring here has been visited since times of eld for its curative properties. I only hope to be able to ease the ache in my back. I'll go have my soak now, if 'tis all the same to you. Can't have Cleona fretting over how long I've been gone.
Ooh! It twinges a bit.
Would seem I owe you a debt of gratitude and an apology. True to your word, you have seen my husband safely to the spring. I was so afeard for his well-being, I couldn't bring myself to sit at home, waiting, wondering. So I followed you at a distance, though now I see I needn't have.
My husband and I are met with persecution everywhere we turn, you see. More than one village we thought to call home has driven us away. That is why we live in so far-flung a place. Gaustafa can bear the judgment well enough, but I cannot. You, at least, have proven deserving of our trust. My husband was right about you. You are a kind soul, indeed. I shall not soon forget this good turn you've done my husband and I. You are welcome to visit us again, if your travels should happen to take you as far as our abode. I would fain lend you my skills as magic archer maester. And I'm certain my husband would be only too glad to take up his blacksmith's hammer for your sake.
You earned a favor from the magic archer maester without even meaning to.
Short though our acquaintance may be, your kindness and sincerity have earned my respect. And so, to aid you in your duty, I would grant you this technique, my most guarded secret as maester of my art.
This way, if you please.
Well done, Arisen. You have acquired a maester's teaching, an important milestone in mastering any vocation.
I shall strive to learn from your example. The time I'd reach new heights of my own.
After all, I owe you a debt of gratitude. 'Tis the least I can do.